Hi everyone, it's Aunt Fernita. Today's story is called Noah Builds a Boat. The memory verse is from Psalm 143, verse 10. It says, "Teach me to do your will, for you are my God." Today's message is the people in God's family want to do His will. When your parents ask you to do something, do you do it without asking why? Do you do it because you love them? Noah was asked by God to build a huge boat. He could have said no. What do you think he did? Noah believed in God at a time when godly men were hard to find. The earth was still young. Only 10 generations had passed since the creation of the world. But people had become so wicked that God decided he should start over. Just one family of righteous people was left on earth. Through that family, God would save the human race and all the creatures he had created. That family included Noah, his wife, their 3 sons, and their wives. God told Noah his plan to destroy the earth with a flood. He also told Noah to build a boat. The boat was to carry Noah, his family, and each kind of animal safely through the flood. The boat Noah was to build was no ordinary boat. It was huge. It was as long as 1.5 football or soccer fields. It was taller than a 4-story building. God gave Noah instructions to be followed very carefully, and Noah set to work. Noah's great-grandfather Enoch had been a righteous man. God took him to heaven so he wouldn't die. Enoch passed on the family heritage of godliness. Methuselah, in turn, passed it on to his sons and to his grandson, Noah. And then Noah had 3 sons of his own, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. So one righteous family, a small group of godly people, was still left on the earth, and they helped Noah build the big boat. That big boat would save the human race and all the different creatures God had created. What an awesome responsibility! Noah and his sons, his uncles, and grandfather were all human. In the years of working together, they probably had some disagreements. But they had an important goal. They had a huge project to finish. They had to work together to follow God's plan. They had to put aside their differences in order to do God's will. Before the boat was finished, God took Enoch to live in heaven, and Noah's other relatives died. Only Noah and his family were left. You may never be asked to build a huge boat. You will never be asked to help save the world from another flood. But God still wants His people to do what He asks. He still wants His people to work together to fulfill His wishes. He may ask you to do another job that requires just as much teamwork. You may need just as much cooperation as was needed for building the ark. Doing God's will is still a part of God's plan for us. Getting along with others is still a part of God's plan too. Listening and working for God was important for Noah and his family, and it's important for us today.
Created and produced by Falvo Fowler, this podcast is read by Frenita Buddy Fullwood for gracelink.net. Animation and artwork by Giorgio Godoy. Audio is post-produced by Faith Toh at Studio El Piso in Singapore. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. The audio engineer was Maurice Bailey.